Sokhov coming along. So they're ready to go. Light blinks. They stand set to explode out of the gates. There they go. They're off and racing. Storm Commander, Sokhov, Glasgow Ghoul. They were the first of them away. Born to Rule pushing up near the inside from Aldalar soon after. Then Forest War. Ultimate Command drifting back after the start. Then Saving Memphis, skipping digits. And towards the tail end of the field is To Rise Again. At the 650 and now Sokhov extends and given a bit of rain, draws clear. Sokhov now out by two lengths. Running second, Storm Commander. Born to Rule third. A length and a half away on the inside, Aldalar covered there on the outside by Royal Gap. Coming towards the home turn, outside of it is Ultimate Command. Getting up on its inside, Forest War, as they set sail for the judge. Skipping digits further back in the field. Sokhov being nursed down to the 250. Led by two, Storm Commander, Born to Rule. Not much else making an impression back in the field. And this is broken clear of them, Sokhov. 100 from home, Sokhov has got them done. Sokhov with the blinkers going on and the gear changes certainly making great effect. Too good for them. Ran them into the ground. Sokhov beat Storm Commander, Born to Rule, and then Aldalar, but nothing made any headway from back in the field. Forest War, Ultimate Commander, Rise Again, followed home by Saving Memphis, Royal Gap, Glasgow Girl compounding, and Skipping Digits back there with her. So Holly Watson gets a first winner for the new season. She's run second on the apprentices list in the recently completed season of racing. She won the provincial title, and Holly on the board with a winner in this 2022-23 racing season on Sokhov. Tongue tie went on, blinkers went on, and putting its best foot forward today, led, extended, got away, and there was not one horse that made any real headway from back in the field. Sokhov dominated. Number two, the winner. Four Storm Commander is second. Third is number six, Born to Rule. Fourth is number 11, Aldalar. 2-4-6-11 Sokhov by Sessions from Bergantina, Philoloma Farms, D. Blackney, A. Bentham, Paul Blinko, trained by Dion Luciani and handled by Holly Watson all the way and with a decisive victory. Has won by 2.5 lengths. It was a length second and third. They broke 60 on a track that did improve after the fifth, upgraded 59.77 the time, 34.98 the last 600. But this was the real Sokhov today. Had won three, but all down the straight five at Pinjarra. Got onto the circle this afternoon and did it sublimely. Win 4 from 10. Storm Commander by Rommel from Girl in a Storm. Nev and Chris Parnham combining their second home. And third, Born to Rule by Universal Ruler from Class Dancer. Clint Johnston Porter, the rider for the Adam Durant stable. Well, to the next event of the day, race 8. The congratulations to Lakhdar Romilly, leading apprentice handicap, 219. They'll jump over 1,400. And without changes there, we'll take you downstairs. And gear changes, most effective blinkers, tongue tie going on, best foot forward, and no contest at the finish, Scotty.
No, exactly. Once she found the front, that's where she likes to do things. And Ian Gladding joins me from Dion's Yard. And Ian, geez, when she finds the front, she's hard to run down.
Yeah, she's a horse, when her confidence is up, she just wants to run. Always shown a hell of a lot of ability. Got lost a little bit last start. We changed the gear today, the blinkers on, tongue tie on. And it was never going to lose.
And watching her trial on a soft 7 and win down the straight on a soft 6, it seems as though the wetter the better for her as well.
Yeah, certainly handles that well. That's not an issue. So, yeah, it's all going very well.
I imagine now for Dion, it's picked through the program and find those 1,000-metre scampers for her.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, there was one on a straight one down on Thursday, and I gave Dion a bit of a rev up. I said, what are you doing, mate? It should have been on Thursday, but he's proven to be right. So
you're giving him a rev up. Now, where is Rev Up, the filly?
Rev it up's going along well. Be here again soon.
And so with Sokhov, is she the kind of mare now that with a little bit of age, a little bit of maturity, she could do the same thing around Ascot? Because, I mean, in theory, that should really suit her.
Yeah. There's no reason why she shouldn't. She's won on good tracks, soft tracks, so there's no reason why I can't do the same thing at Ascot.
Congratulations, well done.
Thank you.
Ian Gladding there giving us an insight into Sokhov here. Some very happy connections made their way into the mounting yard as well. She had the shades on today. I think she had them on as a two-year-old on debut, and she just went way too hard, ran herself off the course at Ascot, never really looked comfortable. And since then, the blinkers have been off, but today they went back on, and so did a number of other pieces of gear, and it seems to have done the trick because she couldn't find the front first up. But today, when she found the fence, she looked a lot more comfortable and a lot more at home. and Holly Watson rode her to perfection. High speed mare, and she was just allowed to run, never looked back. It was a soft victory in the end, Michael.
It was a carbon copy of the stablemate revved up, really, and Holly has a great record on both horses. Holly, first up, things didn't go to plan, but finding the front today, clearly the key.
Yeah, definitely. Obviously, the blinkers probably help her and tongue tie. But, yeah, no, finding the front and getting her to travel is probably her key.
Previous wins down the 1,000-metre straight at Pinjarra. How did she handle the bend today? Obviously, handled it very well.
Yeah, she sort of still wobbles coming around a little bit. She still wants to lay all over the fence and run off the fence. But, yeah, no, she handled it quite well.
Is 1,000 metres just her?
Yeah, definitely. Obviously, today with the tongue tie, I felt like she hit the line a lot better than what she had been at Pinjarra.
What are you thinking with the Ginger Flyer? Good last start win, lines up in the feature race today.
Yeah, hopefully the same. She always tries, so we've got a good gate and hopefully I can do the same.
Well done here. Best of luck for the rest of the day.
Thank you.
Race 7, straight to the front, sock off. 2, 4, 6 and 11, the numbers after race number 7.
No going back.